And we wish each of you a happy, blessed Mother's Day.
Thank you.
Those of you, everybody looks beautiful, and those of you who have decided to have a hattitude, you're looking pretty sharp as well. I tried to have a hattitude. It did not work today. Oh, so this will be my crown. Let us light this candle together in honor of the women, the sisters, those mother figures who have honored God by mentoring us, loving us, and providing for us. May you think upon the one and thank God. Tonight, as we go into the call to worship, we begin with the gathering call, the drum beat, the African sound that speaks to our mothers and the creation of God. Let us prepare ourselves for worship.
Please rise for the call of worship. In the rhythm of our hearts, in the echo of our mother's cries, we gather, bound by a history of resilience, rooted in the soil of our shared struggles. Set us free to walk the path of Miriam, leading with courage and grace, to dance by the shores of liberation. The freedom into existence. Set us free to draw strength from the faith of Esther, who dared to speak truth to power and risked everything for her people, knowing that her destiny was woven with courage. Set us free to embody the resilience of Ruth, choosing loyalty and love over comfort, and strength in the bonds of faith. Even in the face of uncertainty and loss. Let us join together in singing our opening praise.
Thank you.
Let us pray together. Let us pray together a prayer of confession. Merciful God, forgive us, Lord, for the times when our hearts have been closed, when we have chosen selfishness over compassion, and when our actions have fallen short of your perfect love. We acknowledge the moments when our words have wounded instead of healed, when our judgments have overshadowed your grace. Grant us the humility to recognize our shortcomings and the courage to seek forgiveness and reconciliation. Help us to love you as you have loved us, with patience, kindness, and generosity of spirit. May we be vessels of your love in a world hungering for compassion and understanding. Renew our spirits, O God, and guide us back to the path of love and righteousness. May your grace empower us to love more fully, to forgive more freely, and to live in harmony with your will. In the name of Jesus Christ, who embodied your love perfectly, we offer this prayer, trusting in your mercy and grace. Amen. Now let us meditate on the depth of God's love as we listen to the music, allowing his presence to fill our hearts and renew our spirits. Beloved, hear the good news. God's love for us is boundless, his mercy endless. Though we may stumble and fall, his grace is always there to lift us up and to restore us and to set us on the path of righteousness. In the words of Scripture, we find assurance. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John 1:9. Therefore, let us approach the throne of grace with confidence, knowing that in Christ we have found forgiveness and redemption. Receive the assurance of pardon. Your sins are forgiven. Your slate wiped clean. Embrace the freedom that comes from God's unending love and grace. Go forth in peace, rejoicing in the mercy of our loving Savior. Amen.
Good evening, church.
Good evening. Boy, y'all looking sharper than a newly sharpened pencil. Thank you, thank you. It's prayer time. But before we pray, let's take a moment to think back on the women and the mothers that we've lost. If you can, please stand with me and call out the names of those whom you have care and concern for. Noble Harper. Jimmy Jones. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to give you all of our praise. We come together as a community and a church family to pray for our world and each other. We're also here to pray for and celebrate all the mothers and the sisters on this Mother's Day weekend. We know them as my dear, Big Mama, Grand, Grand, and Granny. Some of us call them Miss Margaret, Miss Sherry, Jan, or Miss Doris. But Lord, I want to personally thank you for my mama, Miss Bobby Jean Harper. Woo! She was sweeter than a cotton candy, boy. Oh Lord, we thank you for blessing us with one of your greatest creations. We pray that they feel loved, supported, and heard by us. Let them know that we appreciate them and that we are grateful for everything that they are and are doing in our lives. Now set us free, God, to grow in love and gratitude. Dear God, set us free to be a part of the solutions of change in our world. Set us free to bless and be blessed by one another. Forgive us of our sins as we strive to be all that you've created us to be. God, we stumble, fumble, and fall, but we thank you for it because it all works together for our good. You are an awesome God, and we thank you for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. Now bless us with these messages of inspiration. May their words set us free. We pray that lives be changed, souls be saved, and destinies altered. In Jesus' name we pray. A to the man.
Amen. Grandma's hands. Okay, at this time we ask that you stand, greet one another, and we call this our passing of the peace. Once the music has come to an end, we ask that you come back to your seats. Amen. And greet one another during this time.
Amen. I just love seeing our youth outside preparing to do their thing in the Lord. It always makes me so excited. And the word does too. I know it makes all of us excited. And tonight, we are all about being set free. And we're all about sisters in the spirit of being set free. So let me name the sisters. Rashawn, Kathy, Alyssa, Marjorie. Each one will come up and inspire us tonight as we go deeper into understanding the grace and the depth and the faith of our mother nurturers in our lives and in the community. We're so glad that these sisters will speak. Rashawn, amen.
As we prepare our hearts and minds to hear the word of God, let's be reminded of exactly what this Mother's Day and all Mother's Days bring to us. There's no coincidence that Psalms 9:1 is an emergency call. It's a call out to God for his protection, for his guidance, but most of all for his shelter. Because it says in Psalm 91, "You who live in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and he will, under his wing, you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and a buckler. You will not fear the terror of night, nor the arrow that flies by day, or the pestilence that stalks in darkness, or the destruction that wastes at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your refuge, the Most High, your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, no scourge come near your tent, for he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up so that you will not dash your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder. The young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Those who love me, I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. When they call me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation." Let us pray. Dear Lord, we thank you. We bring you glory. We bring you honor for our mothers, for our sisters, for our aunts, for our mentors. And on this day, Father, we thank you for the promises of Psalm 91, for the protection and for the refuge that you provide. and for pouring that spirit into every mother, every sister, every aunt, and every mentor. Father, as we come today to honor these women, Father, we honor you, for without you, we would not have them. And we are grateful. So let us continue to show our gratitude, our appreciation, and our gratefulness, not just for the gift of those that mother us, but from the gift giver. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Tears and stains. I feel simultaneously deeply blessed and hyper aware of the inadequacy of my own voice in this moment. Good evening, New Hope. The theme for this evening's message is Be Set Free. And first off, I did just want to acknowledge the weight of saying these words and that phrase as a white woman who has benefited from these systems of oppression that my ancestors crafted and upheld, despite my own works to decolonize my mind, my heart, and my actions. So I want to name that first and foremost. I bring this up. I bring this up because I think it's really important to be aware of the very real historical baggage that this concept of freedom can come with because of how it can shape our understanding of what it means to be set free. I want to highlight the difference between a simple legal transaction, which as we know all too well from this country's history, often results in no actual change in reality. What I want to focus on tonight is this concept of true freedom as it's described in the scriptures. And as I thought on what that means, I settled on this idea that it's the ability to act without fear of resistance, backlash, or retribution, this freedom to move without restraint. And upon reflecting on this week's scripture, one line in particular caught my attention in connection to this concept. Towards the end where it says, I will protect those who know my name. When they call to me, I will answer them. I will rescue them. This got me thinking about who knows my name the best. And the people who have the greatest ability to spur me on and make me rise to action and consider things I never would have before, they don't recognize me as Alyssa Trammell McDonald. They don't call me Miss McDonald or even Liz. The humans that can spur me to action at the drop of a hat call me Mama. And this got me thinking on how we call out to God. Because when we call out to God, it's not this performative ceremony. We don't have to have the boxes checked and have it all together. It is that gut-wrenching, I need my mom. And when we do that, God is there like the fiercest mama bear. She is like a broody hen gathering her young chicks up to her. She's like the mom who can't forget her nursing children even if she wants to. And when we call on her, she will keep us by her side. And when we hear that, we tend to conjure these images of safety, but that doesn't actually mean safe as we conceptualize it. The women we talked about at the start of the service were not kept safe in the traditional sense. Esther was only able to speak out for her people as a result of being sex trafficked. Miriam, while she did see freedom and liberation for her people, ultimately died in the desert without seeing a homeland established. And Ruth only acted in faithfulness after she had gone through the devastation of being widowed. Right now, my battlefield, my snakes, my lions on the path are as a foster parent, and my enemies are currently the Orange County Social Services Department and the judicial system, which has reduced my child to a case number. They have pushed off a decision for permanency for 5 months now with no explanation as to why. Time for us to be more bonded with her and her to be more attached to us, and the promise of next time the court case will be the final one where we make a decision. And I am heartbroken. I am more mad than I have ever been in my entire life, and I am really exhausted. I'm celebrating Mother's Day tomorrow, not knowing if I'm gonna have to say goodbye to Sophie forever in 3 weeks. Based off of the whim of a judge and attorneys who've never even met her. So I say this as somebody who is really going through it right now. And I want you to pause and reflect on what are the enemies that are gnashing around you? What are the snakes and the vipers and the lions in your own life? Because it will look different for each one of us. As we navigate our surroundings and our afflictions, what I want us to know and what I'm having to preach to myself is that we are not beholden to our circumstances. We are free simply because we are God's. I can act, I can fight, and I can love my daughter with my entire heart without fear of retribution or resistance. Because God has promised to send angels. God has said that they will move heaven and earth, not to make our troubles disappear, but to be with us as we face them. This entire psalm does not remove the people from the situations of evil. You're not far off, but simply protected from it in the midst. So knowing whether, what gives me strength is knowing whether it's this side of heaven or not, what we're facing is not forever. So that brings me to my point of how should we walk differently knowing that we don't have to flinch from every onslaught. And my prayer is that whatever threat you are facing, that you would not fall to the scourge of apathy, of hopelessness, or bitterness, that you will feel the intentional presence of a God who is not going to be moved from your side. And whether your reward is in this life or the next, you can navigate your day, your week, your month, your year in the confidence and freedom that you are thoroughly adored by a Mother God who not only delights over you with singing and dancing, but also who will mobilize armies to protect her young. Yes. Thank you.
Yes. I think we all have our notes on our phones. Thank you, Alyssa, for sharing that authenticity. And I can say this, I guess, on behalf of the church, that we stand with you and pray for you.
Yes.
Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers, to all the mother figures who are here. God delights in you. He delights in the work that you're doing, whether it's short term, whether it's long term, he delights in that work. This Mother's Day, I wanted us to reflect on the freedom to rest. I can feel it, what Alyssa just said, like I'm exhausted. And I know if I asked mothers to raise their hands, just about the whole room would be like, yeah, I'm exhausted too on a daily basis. Typically, if you ask most mothers, what do you want for Mother's Day? What do we tend to say? Rest, leave me alone. Let me go to my room, do all the chores. I don't want to see anything. I want to go to a spa. I want to relax. Right, anything that has to do with relaxation and rest. And I could say that our Savior understood the real need for rest when he said, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. That's his promise in Matthew 11:28. He invites us to rest. I think of Mary, the mother of Jesus, who from the moment that she knew she was gonna be a mother, she had tremendous joy, but she also had a lot of hardship and stress. She had to leave her homeland. They couldn't find a place for her to have her baby. She had to have it in a manger with a bunch of animals, right? Then the Magi came and were like, yeah, Herod's still after your son to kill him. So they have to escape Bethlehem and they have to run to Egypt. And I'm sure while she was in Egypt, every moment of the day, as a mother, her eyes were on Jesus. She didn't want to leave, you know, let him leave her sight. I'm sure she was over protective over him until Herod died and they can go back to Nazareth. And even then, remember the story where they lost him and she was frantically looking for him. And, you know, that's a lot of stress for Mary, right? But I bet you that even though she had that stress, I'm sure she found rest in knowing who she was raising, that he was the savior of the world. I mean, at the time, she probably just thought he was just the savior of the Jews, but this was the savior of the world, the one who would bring that peace. So he invites us to rest and to be free to rest. Sometimes as mothers, we feel guilty. We feel guilty, you know, that we need time to rest. We feel guilty when we have free time. So sometimes we proceed, if you're like me, to fill up that time, and then you become tired again. But just as a mother nurtures, she guides, she sacrifices for her children, she can nurture herself and sacrifice moments of busyness and substitute them with moments of rest. Today, I want us to celebrate the fact that we can lean on Jesus and we can lean on his everlasting arm, lay our worries on him, lay our burdens on him as moms, and have that boundless freedom in God to rest. God bless you.
We have been blessed tonight. Let us give praise to God for Rashawn, Kathy, Alyssa, and Marjorie. To be set free is to keep moving forward. To be set free is to search for the freedom that rest will bring. That is the message that we have gotten tonight. May we walk in that light as we honor those who have given us birth and given us life, who continue to give us the hope of God by the way in which they have struggled, hurt, found joy, and sought to be at rest. Friends, I am not the third speaker, so you don't have to worry that I'm going to go into another message. I just want to share a few announcements with you as we prepare to stay together as a community as we go over. I want to thank Colleen and her son. They have prepared a full meal for you, for the moms and mother figures and fathers and everybody. So let us go over and continue worship with dinner tonight. I want to encourage you to come to the Gospel Choir concert next week. Amen. It's going to be so good. And I am so thankful to have heard from three of the pastors in Orange County who will not only participate by coming, but they will come forward and share marks of encouragement, words of encouragement with the whole congregation. So I'm thankful for Reverend Pitts, Reverend Curry, Reverend Williamson, who will be a part of the concert. And there will be a finale at the concert in which members of every choir of these three churches will come together for a final song. It's just going to be amazing. And our own minister, Cherie, will be co-hosting this event. Amen? Amen. And let us not forget the bake sale. Oh, the amazing, infamous bake sale. It's going to be great. It's going to be the first time. See what makes this so special? Is this is the first time. This is like our coming out party. This is our first concert at New Hope on this campus. And our first bake sale in the Oliver Center. So you got to come out and be a part of this great, grand event. I also want you to remember that you can take Mother's Day pictures right after church. Our sister Margot has set it up for us to have studio quality pictures in the music hall. Any other announcement about that, Margot? Nope, that's it. Okay, come on over after on your way to the Oliver Center. Come and get your photos taken. Amen. Next week, Pentecost, fire and ice, praising the Holy Spirit. We will have liturgical dancers here. We will have a special presentation that enters us into the presence of the Holy Spirit. We will have people speaking on this stage in Swahili, Russian, Italian, Spanish. Yeah, it's going to be amazing. My mind can't remember all of the languages that we will hear, but it will be a part of a beautiful Pentecost service that you got to come to. Amen? Amen and amen. And then on the last Saturday of this month, it is Friends and Family Saturday. We need you to bring what? Your friends and family. That's right. And I believe there will be a nice Memorial Day meal, probably hamburgers, hot dogs, but I'm not going to put that on the people who are actually hosting because they need to feel free to bring what they bring. Amen. But bring your friends and family at the end of the month. And bring your money and your love for God at the end of this service. We don't take the offering up on the aisles. We take the offering in the back as you go out. It is the last thing that we do as we walk out in praise to God. And we need those praises to go up as we remember all that God has done for us in this church. It is time. It is time to celebrate giving back to God with our tithes and our offerings. So we thank you for doing that. And of course, we would love for you to do it on the way out. If you're not able to, you can sign up to give online. You can come up to the church, or you can put a check in the mail. We'll receive it either way. Let us rise now as we prepare to depart. And do we have any first-time friends or visitors with us tonight? First-time friend, hello. It's so nice to have you here. Hi. Thank you for raising your hand. Maybe you can tell us who you are and how you heard about New Hope. Okay, good to see you. Good to see you. And if you, welcome back. Yes.
We're the Red Front family. It's our first time. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for being here. We pray that you have felt presence and warmth here. We're your neighborhood church on the corner. Come back anytime. We receive you with warm welcome. Amen and amen. Let us pray over the food tonight. Merciful God, we thank you that we can have a meal together, knowing that worship doesn't end in the sanctuary, but we are the bearers of worship out into the community with a time of fellowship and love together. Thank you for that. Bless the hands that prepared the food. May it nourish our bodies in Christ's name. Amen. If there's anyone here who would desire to become a part of this community, all you have to do is come up. Come up during this benediction time and we will receive you. May the grace and the peace and the love of Jesus Christ be with each of you as we prepare to depart. Go out into the world. Be set free to trust in the protection of God and to trust in and be assured by the rest that God promises. In Christ's name, we'll see you in the Oliver Center. Amen. Amen. Amen.